with the sixth pick in the 1998 NBA draft, the Dallas Mavericks select Robert Traylor from the University of Michigan.
Well, we'll talk about the trade in just a couple of minutes, but this moment belongs to Robert Tractor Traylor. Taken number six here in the first round by the Dallas Mavericks, a guy who at times has really tipped the scales, but to his credit has really worked to get himself into playable shape.
Well, he has been a eye-opening surprise around the NBA league tryouts. Everyone is talking about the soft hands. He's in the best shape that he's ever been in. He's down to 280 pounds from over 300. He is a guy who can rebound. He can also score. And you have to look at this pick and say that they're not maybe worrying about filling a need, but what they are doing is picking the best player and not worrying about duplication of positions, because you have A.C. Green and Samaki Walker and the kid Ansi at that position.
Robert Tractor Traylor makes his way to the stage here in Vancouver. As you'll be noted, down to about 288 pounds at 6 foot 7 inches, a Michigan Wolverine center forward. This is a lot of man right here, John Thompson.
Well, and I think he was, as Hubie indicated, smart enough not to have eaten himself out of the game. And he needs to be commended for that, because he's got tremendous hands, and he's very capable of being very dangerous around the block. A lot like Barkley in some ways, a guy who you might say is not large enough to do it, but can get it done with sheer determination, great hands, and great athleticism. I love him, and I'm very proud of the fact that he stopped eating so much.
How about it, Rich?
Quick feet. You know what he can do? He'll be able to go out and take a guy like Kukoc on the perimeter. He has extraordinarily quick feet, and also he has moves to either shoulder in the post inside.
And he willed his appetite to both Rick and I.
That can be good or that can be bad. Let us check in. Is the tractor down there with Craig Sager?
Yes.
Okay,
let's stop to get a burger.
Okay, we'll talk to you in just a second, Sags. On the trade now, the 4-5 swap here, your thoughts, Hubert?
No, I think that it's good for both teams. I like the fact that Carter is going to Toronto. You have Christie in front of him at the two-guard position, but Christie's name has been mentioned in a lot of trade possibilities. His talent is great. I think the Jameson factor for Golden State is excellent. They need that type of a worker and that type of a guy who can get the job done in the front court, not only offensively but board wise and then from a defensive area. So I think it's a great trade for both teams.
Ceremonial swapping of the hats going on down there between Anton Jameson and Vince Carter, and now we can go to the tractor with Craig Sager.
Well, thank you, Ernie. First of all, everybody's talking about the great work ethic, how you've dropped the weight and how great a shape you are and the eye-stopping workouts. Why didn't you get into this shape during college?
Well, in college you look around and you say it's only a 30-game season, whereas playing the NBA, it's 82 games, 90 if you include exhibition. I think just want to be a great player on the next level. I put in the dedication and hard work that it took.
The first hug went to your grandmother, who's always there, Jessie Mae Carter. You look marvelous, first of all. I mean, the whole family looked great there. What kind of shopping spree did you go on? Where'd you go? You guys look great.
Well, my grandson said, Mom, go shopping for some new clothes. And I went out on 9 Mile. I just thank God. I just thank you, Jesus. I thank you, Jesus, first in my life, because he's been a good boy. And he said, Mama, I got to sacrifice and lose some weight because I want to go to the next level. And I just thank God. That's who the head of my life and his life. Because if it wasn't for Jesus, I don't know what would I prayed every night for this day to come.
Well, I'll tell you what, you deserve it. I'll say right now that maybe the Tractor Traylor's appetite for the NBA is greater than his appetite for your peach cobbler. Let's go back to Ernie.
No bouncing.